Fox Deportes. The Big Ten Network. Speed. Fuel TV. FoxSports.com. Fox Soccer. FSN. And Fox Sports. The greatest collection of sports properties in the world.
We are Fox Sports!
Hey y'all, it's racing day, so loud out here I can't hear a thing. Man, the fans are going wild. These drivers came to rock, and no place else but Fox knows how to do it NASCAR style.
Boogity, 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 let's go racing, boys!
Hey, now, here we go, race day. Don't you be going slow, keep that pedal down on the floor. Push it till the crowd can't take no more than air. Since the flag came down the air to the last lap around. Worked all week, it's time to play. Gonna get a little bit sideways.
It's one of the great scenes in all of sports. It's America's greatest race, the 53rd running of the Daytona 500. One driver's dream will be realized today. A high honor will come with high risk at high speed. And these are more than just men behind the wheel. They take on an almost superhero-like look with powers that few can master. And we will watch them try and master this newly repaved track here at the Daytona International Speedway. Welcome to the Daytona 500 pre-race show, delivered by Pizza Hut. And thanks for being with us. You can see where we are to try and get closer to the action. Along with Darrell Waltrip, Jeff Hammond, I'm Chris Meyer.
A new wave and a new season brings a new wave of change to NASCAR as we welcome you, as Fox Sports welcomes you to season 4 of NASCAR Ihop Cup Series competition, kicking off the season with the first points race of the year, the Daytona 500. Now, Speed Weeks itself has been quite the demolition derby with the Budweiser shootout on Saturday afternoon ending on a caution with Caleb Hoffman taking the win. And Thursday's Gatorade duel also ending under caution with Dylan Murway, despite him being in a wreck in last Wednesday's practice session for the Daytona 500, winning that race with a push from the 5 as the field wrecked behind them. Anyways, on tap today in the Daytona 500, we have a gorgeous day. And when I say gorgeous, I mean you could not have predicted gotten a more perfect day to kick off the season four of the NASCAR Ihop Cup Series this afternoon at Daytona. Not a single cloud in the sky. Temperatures can possibly get will be in the mid to upper 60s today. But here's the best part. There was rain overnight, but there is not a cloud in the sky. Anyways, without further ado and any more stalling, let's take a look at your starting lineup. KFC Cups, in row 1, we got the Bass Pro Shop Chevrolet and the Dollar General Toyota. Row 2 finds the Nationwide Insurance Chevrolet and the Drive 10 Hunger Chevrolet. Row 3 finds the Mac Tonight Chevrolet and the FedEx Express Toyota. Row 4, one of Alvin Alonso's better starts on his best start on a plate track since season 1 at Talladega Infield. And the M&M's 75th Anniversary Toyota. Row 5, we got the Farmers Insurance Chevrolet and the AdvoCare Ford. Row 6, we got the Smithfield Foods Ford and the Bath and the 3 car. Row 7 finds the Aris Internet Modems Toyota and the 33 car. Row 8 finds the Ortho Fire Ant Killer Ford and the 56 car. Row 9 finds the Pennzoil Ford, the Motorcraft Ford. Row 10 finds the Menard Chevrolet and the Caterpillar Chevrolet. Row 11 finds the 15 car and the 29 car. Row 12 finds the 7 car and the 25 car. Row 13 will find the Nature's Bakery Chevrolet and the White Deuce Ford. Row 14 finds the Napa Auto Parts Toyota and the 83 car. Let's try to mic up Caleb Hoffman, who's currently trying to go for the Speed Weeks trifecta in this race. Hey, this is DW. This is Caleb Hoffman in the Fox Sports booth. This is Hey, Caleb Hoffman. This is Daryl Waltrip in the Fox Sports booth. You got us? Yeah, DW. I got you. Man, you've been pretty lucky this week in Speed Weeks. You won the Budweiser shootout after being in that late race scramble where you slid through the grass and you won the first dual race. How do you feel about your car and your chances today to win the 500? It's going to be pretty interesting with this new package and it being as hot as it is and how slick it might be. You might see a lot of handling issues today. You might see some cars try to slide up. Maybe kiss the wall. You're going to see a lot of three wide, but at the same time, we were in a lot of smaller packs, like, you know, 10, 15 car packs in practice during speed weeks. This is the first time drafting with all 34 cars, so a lot of us don't really know how the air is going to play into effect, but yeah, our Aerosurin at Toyota is pretty strong in the draft. I mean, we can link up to bumpers with a bump drafting rule, but you can't. And with the new bump drafting rule, so it's going to be pretty interesting, especially on a late restart, where it's going to be find the nearest partner who will be lucky enough to push you and then push him to the end. So, yeah, hopefully we'll go for the Speed Weeks trifecta. And, alright, good luck down there. Thanks, DW. Caleb Hoffman will be starting this race from the 13th position this afternoon in the Daytona 500. Anyways, some race facts. 34 cars, 16 laps, and KFC Cups is on the pole. Some things to watch for. The Speed Weeks trifecta. Can Caleb Hoffman join Season 2 Dylan Murway as a is the second guy to complete the Speed Weeks trifecta, winning the Budweiser shootout, which will be a night race next year, by the way, winning the his Gatorade 125, and also winning the Daytona 500. No other driver has done that. All right, DW, how do you think these drivers are feeling right now? Right now, their hearts are racing, knowing that this is the first lap, that this will be the first lap of the new season, the first time points will be awarded, and everybody wants to get those 5 extra points to lead a lap and possibly get in the chase. Every position, 1 point, every win will automatically put you in the chase, so it's going to be pretty wild today. All right, DW, why don't you reach up there, pull those belts tight one more time. All right, new season, boys. Hopefully we'll get a good, clean start here. Clean start. Bring them down. Bring them down. Bring them down. Pace car. Bring them down. Boogity, boogity, boogity. Let's go racing in season 4, boys. think the reason that 20 really got a big shove going down into turn one, maybe it's because he wants to push him to those 5 bonus points, but looks like fruits of his labor won't really fly out well, because look who's going to come on the outside with a big push from the 11. That's the 24 car, Jacob Tube. Big push from him. Side by side coming off turn 4. Looks like the 88's going to try to maybe stick it 3 wide. But question is, who's going to be going with him? Looks like the 1 will. And that's 5 extra bonus points for leading the first lap of Season 4 to the 20 car Zach Speed. It looks like the 20 may also be drifting back in the middle groove. Gotta be careful. And they're already 3 wide already. 3 wide through these couple rows. And I mean, look at this pack. There's Jonathan Morrison, had a rough year last year. Hoping to start off the year with a good run, maybe a win. Steve. I talked with crew chief Slugger Labby here yesterday about how rough season 3 was. I mean, for these guys. And yes, Slugger Labby said, we had a good car, but we just got caught up in other people's messes way too often. Hopefully, we're going to try to minimize a lot of mistakes this year. And we had a good car in the duels. And we were fast at Saturday practice, and they feel they got a good car to win today. And when a driver puts that much focus or confidence in his team, you know it's going to be one of the better days. But then again, too much confidence can get you in trouble. 3 wide all the way through this field, and look at how some of these cars are just being pushed. I mean, that one has not left the back bumper of that 88. I mean, a couple times, he almost picked him up off the ground. Going through turn 1. Ooh. Yeah, there's got to be that slight bit of patience. I mean, NASCAR said in the drivers' meeting for 2010 that they're going to be a little less less strict on bump drafting for season 4, so you're going to see a lot of guys lock bumpers. Oh, crash, triable. Oh, big. Oh my god. Big wreck. Cars all over the place. Looks like KFC Cup Series is involved. Oh man, you hate to see this early in the race. Several hard hits. The 17 into the inside wall. The 27 into the side of the 14. The 6 is involved. Oh man, look at that. More cars piling in because they got nowhere to go. It's like the 16 of Brendan Little has a little bit of damage. Caution flag is out here for the first time this season in the Daytona 500 for a multi-car pileup. And there are some cars that are still wrecking. They're not done. The 55 piles in, and the 9. With the pretty heavy shot. Hot to the outside. Then he gets into the inside wall. Now the caution comes out. Ah, man. We told you 3 wide racing and bump drafting, especially in big groups.
The result can be often pretty catastrophic.
And look, you got some pretty strong cars in there. I mean, you got KFC Cup Series up against the inside wall. Remember, they put in a new hit of a safer barrier there this year. That barrier there a couple years back for Kyle Busch incident. Alvin Alonso, he also tested those safer barriers. Jake Fasinger, Darnell Matthew. Noah Spaulding involved, a little, not as much damage as some of these other cars, but he does have damage. See the, .27 went down on his car. Peyton Beasley parked up against the inside wall here, toward outside wall towards turn one. And he's climbing out. Alvin Alonso with a big hit. They're going to have to throw the red flag because of all the debris and pieces that have just been strewn from this accident. See Jessica Shelton. Lap 3 is when we hit the big one. I know most of last year we waited pretty well into the later stages of this race to have the big one, but pretty unfortunate today that we've torn up about 10 cars, and I don't know, I think about 2 of them can continue. KFC Cup Series, if he just let that car slide and he didn't get hit, had those 2 big hits, I mean, he would have continued, he would have been fine. 27, he's out of that thing. I know it's dark because I saw the 5 and the 17, they were really shoving each other, trying to get that inside lane to go, and then it just turned into a big pile up right here. That's the problem with this new bump drafting rules that they put in place this year. All the rest of the cars stopping off turn 4. After a big crash early on in the Daytona 500. You're watching NASCAR on Fox. As we look down in the garage, you see Jessica Shelton's team already getting worked on her car. Jessica Shelton is standing by with Jeannie Salasco. Jeannie, well, unfortunately, Daytona 500 came to the end for some of these guys. 3 laps in. What can you tell us what happened there? I don't know. I mean, I saw the 17 just get loose because the 5 was pushing way too hard through the travel. Then I see him overcorrect. My spotter's telling me, check up. But check up. Next thing you know, I'm into the back of the 33. Really hate it for Schick Extreme 3 guys, our Peak guys, and our Peak Schick Turbo Shavers guys back at the shop. They put together such a good car, and then 3 laps into the Daytona 500, idiots happen. Idiots just destroyed the field. Really hate it for guys, so on to Vegas, I guess. What she brought up in her interview is how tightly packed these guys were 3 laps into a race. Into this thing. Packed these guys were 2-3 wide. And you don't really have as much room to make your way out of an incident when you're 3 wide at a place like Daytona. Whereas Talladega, it's much wider. You can run 4 wide. If there's a spin, your chances of missing the rack are a lot higher. Whereas here at Daytona, if there's a wreck in the tri-oval, it just doesn't bode well. There's still a couple cars that took some hard hits. Alvin Alonso is one of them, and he's staying by with Dick Berger. Well, Alvin, unfortunately, hit three laps into the Daytona 500. You just got you find yourself triggering the big one. What happened? Well, the five just wouldn't lay off our bumper on the front stretch, and he moved to the left. I spun, tried saving it, but the car just jerked right. Right next thing you know, I'm plowing into the wall. Hate it that you gotta be taken out by an idiot like that. You know. Three laps into the Daytona 500. You really hate it being taken out like by an idiot like that. That is 11 cars destroyed. Three of these guys can continue. The other eight, unfortunately, they are done. So that's eight drivers. You can cross off the names of the of chances to win the Daytona 500. See, the red flag has turned to a caution light now. So people can begin work. And unlike the Monster Energy Cup Series, see the 55, 25, 15 down pit road. Unlike that series, you can take as much time as you want under this caution, well, at least till the one to go where you gotta go. You can take as much time as you want to repair and come back to the racetrack if you have to go to the garage. And it looks like 55 can be added to the list. He's done. See the crew chief signaling. Put it on the truck. Just like that, three laps in, and 10 cars are gone. Getting ready for the restart here. Remember, if there is a red flag, the lap counter and caution flag, sometimes, depending on the severity of the wreck, the lap counter will freeze the lap counter, and then they'll bring the cars around and not have the race end, you know. It's a lot shorter. Anyways, pace car is off. Hopefully we'll have a little bit of a safer route this time for, you know, bump drafting. Or attempting to bump draft this time around. Pace car is off. Green flag back into the air. That idiot really didn't get a good start that time, because he almost spun right there in that car in the tri-oval. See him losing a lot of spots. I don't think anybody wants to pick him up, because nobody's... Look at him just drop like a rock. It's because the 11 and the 20, they had a plan. And whoa, look at that 5 car really get shoved out right there. And shoved out, looks like he's going to probably drop back a few spots as the 11 gets taken out of his line. Remember? That, my friends, is what you call side drafting. Basically, what you do is you get up next to a car. You don't ride on their door like the 24 did, but you basically load that air all on the left front of that car, and you just push them, and you just get them loose. Definitely a effective one to run. The one car tried looking, but thought better of it. Anyways, look at Grayson Alcevedo way to the outside right here. 20 gets let in this time. He ends up... The 11... 18 gets let in this time. He's ended up pushing the 16 in car. to see Hunter Miller coming back with a big push from the 41. Now look at the 1. He's going to come up, try to maybe block, but he almost spun that car around on that car right there. This Jacob Tube continues to lead the Daytona 500. Look at Jonathan Morrison way trying to pull his way through there. And could he take the lead right here? He might. They are side by side. 24 concedes the run lead back to the 7. Gives the lead to the 7. And now they're 3 wide again. Jonathan Morrison, leader at Daytona. Folks, if you don't know, the significance of the 3 car in NASCAR, it's because one of NASCAR's best, Dale Earnhardt, 7-time champ, just took the lead here at Daytona. And Jonathan Morrison has taken over for that ride, over that ride since season 1. He's consistently driven it. And he just took the lead here at Daytona. A few laps before the halfway money gets paid off here at Daytona, looks like. Remember, you got him. The way this draft works is if cars get side by side, it allows the leader to pull away, but that the leader can't get away too far, otherwise it's just gonna turn into a big mess, and the group's gonna eat the other cars up, just like that. You see the 3 car get out now on the backstretch, and then the 24 catches him as around goes the 7 here off the bumper of the 19. Spinning. Oof, caution is out. End of the wall. Second caution of the Daytona 500. That is the 7 of Chris Washer. Ever since his win in season 1 at California, he had his scary crash there in season 2. And unfortunately, it hasn't gone well for him since. A couple pretty hard crashes, and he just got turned into the wall. And just like that, we have our third caution just shoved out of line. That's a shot. Glad he's out of that car. See him take that hit to the inside. He missed that opening that jutted out, and then, even then, if he was lucky, he missed the opening, the way the wall juts out off turn 4 when he spun. He's lucky he missed it, otherwise we would have taken a much worse impact. Worse impact that time than he did. It's there. Now, there are 22 race cars on this racetrack. As you see, Chris Washer has taken his car to the garage. Unfortunately, he will not be in contention to win a Daytona 500. yet another restart right here. A little past halfway in the Daytona 500. Hope you guys are enjoying your Sunday afternoon here on Fox. Here's what I like to call a little bit of a radio remix on this race. All right, fellas, get ready for a good 2017. Everybody stay safe down there. Let's start this season with a bang. 10-4. Ready. Green. All right, three wide. Watch 24. Three wide. The racket. Come up. Oh, We're in it, boys. It's junk. That's a sign of spotter radio, spotter and team radio, and what it's like here at Daytona. Presented exclusively by Liberty Mutual Insurance. Liberty Mutual, helping drivers worry less. Getting ready for another restart this afternoon here at Daytona. Now, when you're Jonathan Morrison and Jacob 2 on the front row, Gibbs teammates in row 2, Grayson Alcevedo and Brendan Little row 3, Caleb Hoffman, Hunter Miller row 4, and Jonathan Wishard and Hunter Rizzoni round out our top 10. Pace cars off, bring the field down, green flag back into the air. That 24 got a big time shot from the 20. He's actually able to come down in front of them, and now they're clear. They're gone. New leaders here at Daytona. Jacob 2 with a big head of steam from that 20. And it looks like Brendan Little's got another huge run up that outside lane. The field forms back up. And how about, three wide here. A little sketchy for a little bit of three wide racing. Here is where you're going to see a lot more urgent mistakes, so urgency, a lot more take and a lot less, heck of a lot less give on the racetrack. You're going to see guys force their cars into holes they've never been in all practice, even the shootout, or heck, the duels race, or even the shootout. You're going to see a lot of guys force their cars into holes they wouldn't normally force them into, but they're doing so today. Look at that big push from the 88 of Apollo Moon. Fortunately, gets stalled out. Now he's got his teammate pushing him. And did you see the way that the field has been moving back and forth? Did you see the way the 24 brought the 20 and the 16 up to cover the outside lane? Then brought him back down. Well, that time when he brought him down, it didn't really work, as you see Brendan Little trapped in the middle lane coming off turn 2. And it looks like he's going to be going backwards. And look at Hunter Miller. Really, he's been another one that's mastered the art of side drafting here in the Daytona, here today at Daytona. He really hung on the door of the 20 car just to get his way in there. The 20, let's see the 88 coming down.
Hendrick cars 1, 2, 3 here at the Daytona 500. Paul Moon on the outside with a push from the 10. He's got some extra help this time. This time it's from the 4 of Dylan Merway, whom we have not heard from all day. As there are 4 laps to go in the Daytona. I'm sorry, there are 5 laps to go here in the Daytona 500. Look at this. I mean, their car is literally shoving inches apart from each other. These guys are the best drivers in the world, and they're literally pushing each other to the limit right now. I don't want to be in that middle lane if I were you. Look at that. Jacob Duke down to the inside. Back to the top side. Down to the bottom. Hunter Miller has not left that 24's bumper right here. And in this position is where the guy out front can't be pushed too far, otherwise, far unless he's got a pusher pushing him, like you see the 24 and the 5, they're really shoving each other in this group. They're just, oh, they're all over each other. Now they're blocking all three lanes right now. Three lanes of traffic. Oh my gosh. Three laps to go. How can the best drivers in the world deal with all this crazy? Just keep it together for this long. Here, let's go on board if somebody's in the outside lane. Let's go on board the 41. You can see how tightly packed he is up on the outside. Just a lot of momentum is stalled out on the outside lane as trouble. So we got a car up in the wall right here. Looks like behind them, the 22 of Zoex Moon has scraped the wall off too. No yellow. Maybe just a handling issue, just got the air loose off the 42 and almost went around. Yeah, I think she's got a tire issue. She's got something wrong with that car. It doesn't look pretty right here. As you see, now the caution looks like it's going to come out. Tire just tore apart on the 22. Okay, now is where things are going to get interesting. Oh, reports that 22 just pushed us so far off the corner, just put us in the wall. 22 just pushed us into the wall right there, guys. Plain and simple. Can you bring it around? Yeah, it's fine. We just tore up the car. The fender square. Try not to tear it up too much. That's Crew Chief Todd Gordon. Crew Chief and also Crew Chief Joey Logano in the Monster Energy Cup Series. Let's go back. Back and let's look at the onboard of the 42 car. See, all prunes all the way through this corner. He's really just hasn't let go of that bumper. And unfortunately, just it's been pushing. Car stepped out, slapped the wall. That right there is just trying to get a little bit of air to the car. He tries to go to the left. If he went to the right, he would have taken out the 43, 21, and basically the entire back half of the field. But, fortunately, just pushed it in the wall. Also looked like the 15 did get loose, but he did save it. Okay, now is where things get interesting. And by the way, Zoex Moon is on pit road. Zoex Moon guy on the radio said the suspension is killed on the impact, and I don't know how we're going to get this car fixed. fixed range. They're going to try to beat out the fender as best as they can.
But they do know that there is... that they got a lot of work to do. Bring it in, bring it in. Bring it to the garage, guys. It's done. It's done. Car's killed. It's killed, guys. It's... I can't even fix it. You heard it there. You see Todd Gordon signaling to his pit crew. Bring it to the garage. Actually, never mind. They're going to try to piece together the fender. Get a new, entirely new fender so I can beat it out. Turns out they do that. And this means they actually might be going back in this thing. Anyways, next reminder, next Sunday coverage, we're going to be in Sin City for the Kobalt 400. Coverage begins at 3 p.m. Eastern on FS1 for race day, then tune in at 4:30 p.m. on FS1, then tune in to Fox at 4:30 for the pre-race show. And then at 5 p.m. Eastern is the Kobalt Tools 400. Gonna be a nice little day-to-night race. One of those kind of races where the track will change. First intermediate race of the year. Gonna see some sparks flying under the Vegas lights. It's gonna be a fun one. Can be seen on Fox. But meanwhile, we got our own interesting little hold'em match here on the restart. It's pretty interesting. Right now, we were going to talk about this earlier, but the incident of the 22 interrupted us. Is the line that goes is going to be the line that more often than not, especially in the Ihop Cup Series, has the same motor. So right now, the 24, his only Chevy that's in these first five rows is the blue of Jonathan Morrison. We don't know if the Gibbs car is maybe pushing him out or playing a run of their own. We don't know that. But right now, it looks like the on this late restart, this is a regular restart, by the way. On this late race restart, looks like the 5 would definitely be at a more advantage. He's got his teammate behind him. He's got the 10 of Blake Dillon behind him as well. And he's also got the 4 as well. So the only oddity in these first 5 rows behind the 5 would have to be the 16 car because of Ford power. And we're also getting reports that the 88 may be down on power. Matt. Apollo Moon just got the radio, told crew chief Greg Ives that we have power issues. It looks like it may be laying down a cylinder. She said, try to get out of there as best as you can. It's been acting this way on the restart, so they are going to switch him to battery 2 right now. I mean, that's no worse of a feeling to have the battery potentially give out on you, especially on a late on a restart like this where 2 laps left in the Daytona 500 and these guys are going for the win and possibly $1 million. A chase berth is on the line as well. It's gonna be a wild one right here. Jacob Tube and Hunter Miller, two of the best cars all day in the Daytona 500 on the front row. Zach Speed and Apollo Moon with a battery issue. How will this play out? Jonathan Morrison, Blake Dillon, row 3. Joshua Leanbatch and Brendan Little in row 4. SportsCenter Cup Series and Dylan Merway in row 5. How will the battery issue of the 88 play out? Oh, he doesn't go. He's not going to go, and he's turned into the wall, sideways. The 10 is collected. Oh, my God. More cars continue to pile up behind. Oh, that was not something that they wanted to see as cars continue to crash. 88 slams into the pit wall. Cars all over the place. Here, just as these guys come to green, we have a 55 mile an hour big one. Shush. Caution is out. Here in the Daytona 500, two laps left in scheduled distance. The 4 of Dylan Murway has damage. The 88 of Jonathan Wishard slammed into the pit wall. Everybody is okay. Battery just...
It wouldn't go. Alright there, guys. That's what he said. It wouldn't go whatsoever. The second red flag of the day is out, by the way, here at Daytona. They're going to have to clean this track up.
Several favorites for the win. In fact, this took out the other three Stuart Haas cars in this wreck. The other three Stuart Haas cars just got taken out in this accident. The 4 and the 10, they're done. The 1 is done. The 88 is done. And look who this brings into the picture. Here is they stop the cars on the back stretch. Now they wait out this red flag here in the Daytona 500. Again, just going to remind you, give you tickets to these next few races. You got Las Vegas coming up. That can be seen on Fox. California can also be seen on Fox, 3 p.m. Eastern. Atlanta can be seen on Fox at noon Eastern. Texas can be seen on Fox at 12:30 p.m. Eastern. Brighton, the first Friday night race of the year, can be seen 8:30 p.m. on FX. Then you see Bristol. Bowman Gray gets his first second event of the year, the Ticket Galaxy 300. That can be seen on FX. It's also a Friday race. So we got some good short tracks and fan favorite tracks coming up for us here in the coming weeks. Here's Grayson Alcedo. He got hit and then just drove into the grass. He's done. So of this group, in this eight car incident, the 18 and the 41, they're the only cars that are actually able to continue. The rest of these cars, unfortunately, get to add to the growing list of drivers. We have, of the 34 drivers that started the Daytona 500 today, we have 4, 8, 12, 16 of them. Almost half the field is in the garage right now. You know what this means? We're going to go green, white, checkered to settle the first race of the year in the NASCAR Ihop Cup Series. We have 20 cars on. We have literally six. Eighteen cars on the racetrack. So almost half the field is in the garage right now. And a reminder of the green, white checkered overtime rules. If the leader, there we get three attempts. The leader makes it to the white flag. Shut the hell up. The race is official, and if a wreck happens, next flag will end the race. If there is a wreck, and before the leaders get to the white, they'll line them up, and they'll do it again. Three tries required. Before, if it is on the third attempt, if a wreck happens on the last lap, depending on how severe it is, they'll let them race back. Or if they need to roll medical attention, if there is a wreck on the last lap, they will end the race effectively. Anyways, first attempt at overtime. Jacob 2 in the 24, Hunter Miller in the 5. Going to take the green. Of these 18, who will be the first to the to the checkered flag to win one of NASCAR's biggest races? Here we go.
Twenty splints tires. Come on, watch it. It's just you and the. You in the 24.
Whoa, that three gave a big shove right there.
And a lot of cars forcing their way down to the bottom. As there's literally positions everywhere swapping.
And look at the 29 of Eminem's Cup Series. Now he's pushing the 24 car. He could be a factor. Oh, he's going to probably almost move him.
Right here.
Caleb Hoffman has dropped. I'm sorry, Zach Speed has dropped. He is confirmed. He is out of fuel. That's a sick feeling. If he is he's far enough out of the way, they'll let him race back. They will not throw the caution. He is currently on the apron.
And here they come, 3 and 4. No way they're going to be making it all the way back around right here unless they wad them up. They got to watch out for that 20. And now the caution comes out. Now this adds into the question. Which of the leaders are able to make it back? With this extra bit of strategy that... that was just now brought in because the 20 ran out of fuel. Now the 5 is going to be on the inside lane. And there's really not much of a major consistency of manufacturers in the first four rows. Well, more in the inside, outside row than the inside because, well, Chevrolet-wise, Hunter Miller has got the 24 and 29 on the inside row. The only problem is the 2 is the outlier. Here, it's an even mix. Well then, see the record pushing the 20 to pit road. The fuel did run dry. Oh man, that sick feeling in your stomach when you know that fuel basically costs you a chance to win the Daytona 500. See Zach Speed down on pit road, getting filled up, which also means we're going to see a pretty interesting restart right here. As you see the couple guys, mainly some guys on the inside lane,
are taking some fuel to top off. Yeah, guys, like the 48 is now electing to stay out. It means he'll push the 5. So you got the 24, 21, the 15, 42, and 43, and 18 have all elected to come down pit road. So this means we got a hornet there in the middle of a potential hornet's nest here on this restart. Attempt 2 in overdrive. Here we go. Hunter Miller, see him signal that hand out that window. There's that hand signal. Dale Earnhardt won a race strictly by getting a guy behind him to push him all the way to the front. Look at that. The 18 really forced his way up through there. Air to get with the 19 and Caleb Hoffman, but the question is, he's got a lot of fuel as they make it around right here. Caleb Hoffman he's pushed. He's going on the outside lane. The question is, who's going to go with him? Jackson Hunter having to push the 3. Nate Sherman and Hunter Miller. Teammates are working with each other. How about Eric Gamer and Darnell Matthew? Both these cars were part of the big pileup on lap 1. On lap 3 of this race. And now, look. They are all the way up in this mix. This mix up to win the Daytona 500. That's the work of restrictor plates. The 5 can't get even with the 48. 8 white flag in the Daytona 500. Look at this group forming up in the outside lane. 3 wide all the way through this field. Wide, about 4 cars deep. Hunter Miller can't seem to get clear. The 3's been hanging on his door pretty much all through that lap. Here comes Jonathan Morrison pushed to the front. Hunt this time. Now if you're the 5 car, what do? Hunter Miller, if you're Jonathan Morrison, stay behind. Do you stay behind or you go for the run? Look, all the way to the outside, down to the bottom. That doesn't look pretty. That does not look pretty right here. He can't quite get there. He's going to do it again. He's going to go to the bottom. And, oh, he turned him. Jonathan Morrison up into the wall. Several cars spinning. We got one sliding through the grasses. Hunter Miller is now the Daytona 500 champion. But look at this heavy impact carnage behind. Oh, man, there's still going at it here in the tri-oval. Hell yeah, boys! Wow! Oh, we got... that's big time crash here to end the Daytona 500. They're still wrecking here at the checkers. The 2 shot up the racetrack up to 22 or 42 and 25. Hunter Miller is the new Daytona 500 champion. Last year, his engine blew up, causing the very first caution of season 1. This year, played his cards right. And he just won the Daytona 500. And these wins do not stay with you for the rest of your season. They do not stay with you for the rest of your career. No, sir. They stay with you for the rest of your life.
Hell yeah, boys. Great job. Thank you. You gave us a good car there. Eric Kenny. Awesome job. You're buying tonight, man.
You totally earned that. I mean, you've seen the way
that.
The way that he drove pretty much all day long, just an amazing job, but you got a feel for Jonathan Morrison, though. One of the strong, had a pretty lucky car, caught some brakes, led a couple laps in the day, led a few laps today. Just the late restart issues.
So they figure out who is where, the cars that did crash. The 2, 9th, and then we got, wow.
Hunter Miller, the man of the hour here in the Daytona 500.
Came down here and do a burnout for us, boys.
Gonna be driving past the accident scene. Sunoco would like to congratulate Hunter Miller on his big win today in the Daytona 500. There he goes, doing a tribute to the man in black.
I don't care who you are. That's cool right there.
Man in black all the way around. This 2.5 mile joint. See him holding the three fingers out the window. Hey, that was a very, very good finish with what little cars that
the handful of cars that did finish. All the cars that were involved in the last pileout before the on the first green white checkered have been checked and released, and some of these cars you'll wonder why they finished the way they did. Caleb Hunter Miller with a good strong win today in the Daytona 500. Caleb Hoffman, unfortunately, he came up short. Nate Sherman, third. Joshua Leanbatch in fourth. Jacob Tube, fifth. Darnell Matthews, sixth. Eric Gamer, seventh. Robert Smith, first full season for driving the 2 car, finishes eighth. Noah Spaulding finishes ninth, despite getting caught up in the big pileup early on. Same with the 15. Great job to both of them. Derek Lewis finishes 10th. Zach Speed, despite running out of fuel on the first green white checkered attempt, he is the winner of the Daytona. He finishes 13th. Finishes 11th. Mason Powers, 12th. Jonathan Morrison did finish 15th or 13th. He did get out of the car. However, they are taking him to the medical center. They're also taking him to the Halifax Medical Center as a precaution. It is a precautionary measure. He is fine. He did get out of the car, shaken up, but he did get out of the car, getting hit in the back by the 29, then drilled in the door by the 43. The Hot Wheels 44, 14th. Xavier Sadreska, 15th. Eminem's Cup Series, 16th, after plowing under the 3 on the last lap. Zoex Moon, 17th, after blowing a tire late in this race. Basically, anybody from the 41 on back were involved in some sort of accident. So you see, 41, he finished 18th. Hunter Rizzoni, 18th, after being caught in that late pile. And surprisingly, Jonathan Wishard, Joshua Leanbatch, after being caught up in that crash, he still managed to finish 4th with a smashed in rear end. That is pure luck right there. Then Blake Dillon, 20th.
Then you see the rest of the field. Dylan Murway, he won the second Gatorade duel on Thursday. He will not, he unfortunately will end up finishing today in 22nd. Then you see the rest of the field skating by your screen, and then the cars are involved in the big pileup on lap 3. It's unfortunate, but for those guys, but one man is currently smiling down, smiling in victory lane. Hunter Miller doing a nice little Dale Earnhardt tribute, emotional in victory lane, but congratulations to him. Tune in next Sunday, 3:30 p.m. Mountain Time, 5:30 p.m. Eastern, for the Kobalt Tools 400. We will see you then. But until then, it's been a fun Daytona 500, fun IHOP Cup Series Speed Weeks. And all I have to say is congratulations to the five of Hunter Miller.